I've been obsessed with two movies this past month. One was dark, intense, and action-packed. And the other was The Batman. I love turning red, if you can't tell. Which you probably can't, since I'm wearing green. I am wearing red shoes, though, so I guess that counts. But yeah, I really loved turning red, and honestly, I just want to talk about it, because why not? My favorite thing about the movie is Maymay's friend group. One thing I think we take for granted as kids are our friends. When you're a kid, there's not much to gain from being someone's friend. No one has money, no one has cars. But when you're older, this person may just want to be your friend because you're rich, or you're TikTok famous, or you're Spider-Man. These girls have May's back, and May has theirs. Except for that one time when she threw them under the bus, but hey, that's in the past. I also loved 4Town. 4Town is so cool. We need the 4Town album, Disney. They're like a mixture of the best boy bands put into one. It's really cool. Not to mention the aunties. The aunties were legendary. And that Ritual song, I don't know, it's just such a vibe. But even though I love this movie, I've been seeing a lot of interesting critiques about it, and honestly, I just want to give my opinion. One criticism I saw is that Maylin isn't relatable because she's a 13-year-old Asian girl. But I don't see how that's relevant, because I feel like what she goes through is relatable regardless of her race. Most of us have been embarrassed by our parents in some fashion. I'm still glad there's Chinese representation in this movie, but I feel like when people see a main character of another culture, they just shut down. They assume they can't relate. But one thing that Disney does that I actually really appreciate is how they try to represent different cultures in their movies. I think their goal is to show how, even though all of us are from different places and we speak different languages, we're more connected than we may think. When I was a little kid, I had a doctor's visit, and while I was sitting in the waiting room, there was another kid. As an only child, I was always super excited to see other kids, so I tried to talk to him. But he spoke a different language. So we both kind of just started to look at the TV, which was playing Tom and Jerry. I remember him and I laughing our butts off at Tom give Jerry the Will Smith treatment. We didn't understand each other's words, but we understood each other's humor, and I think that's really cool. Kind of crazy to think about. Someone could be your best friend, and you have no idea because they speak a different language. Or take it a step further, what if your soulmate is on the other side of the world and they speak another language? Just something to think about. Another criticism I see is that parents aren't happy Pads were in the movie. They're acting like they showed something disgusting and inhumane. You could see Pads out in a grocery store. You forgot your I feel like showing Pads is the same as showing toilet paper. A girl's monthly cycle is just as normal as a boy pooping. Because girls don't poop, right? If they did, that would be inhumane and disgusting. A lot of people say the characters in this movie are obnoxious and annoying, but I don't think it's meant to be obnoxious. I think it's just meant to show how kids act. They're kids. And even if you think they have obnoxious moments, each of these characters are still unique and different. Priya is obviously super chill and calm. Abby's loud and energetic, and Miriam is like right in the middle. When I see Maymay's character, I see myself. She's not just the shy, weird girl, she's the confidently weird girl. That was me as a kid. I was super extra, but I didn't care because I was just having fun. I was a kid. But as I got older, I did become more self-aware and self-conscious. I used to not care if people judged me, but as time went on, I did, and I needed an outlet. And that's actually why I started making these videos. For May, her outlet is her friends. She feels like she can be her true self around them without judgment. I can relate to how May sort of hides part of herself from her mom. It's not like she's living a double life. She's not the Batman. But there are things May likes that she pretends not to like around her mom, like 4Town. I didn't always tell my mom I wanted to make videos. She was a straight-A student and actually the valedictorian of her high school, so for me to say, hey mom, I actually want to make videos on the internet, it was kind of scary. But one of the best characters in this movie, to me, is the dad.
You know it's us, yeah.
And it's crazy because he talks the least, but I love the scene where he's sitting with May and he tells her how he thinks we shouldn't suppress certain parts of ourselves, not even the ugly ones. Rather, to learn how to live with the good and the bad. And I feel like that's the point of the whole movie. Mace Panda represents when we blow up and get super angry, or sad, or even happy. That's obviously why it's triggered by emotions. And throughout the movie, May tries to suppress these emotions, aka the panda, just as her mother and her mother did. But eventually, May decides to break the generational cycle of holding in how she feels. She keeps her panda, and she doesn't get rid of who she is to please others. And I think Disney's trying to tell us with this movie that we shouldn't either. This video was sponsored by your mom. Get it? Because I'm not actually sponsored. Late April Fool's prank, I don't know. I know this video is a little late. I mean, the movie came out literally a month ago. But I still want to post because I actually have a bigger video planned. It's just taking forever. So I wanted to give this as sort of filler, I guess. So I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you didn't, I don't know. I'm sorry, I guess. Take care of yourselves.